Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you another wig review. Now there are plenty of websites out there if you are looking for a wig for cosplay or if you just enjoy wearing wigs just casually around the house when you go out shopping, but there is one company that is my tried and true company that I go to, and that is Wig Is Fashion. Now Wig Is Fashion has some extremely beautiful designs. They actually have a section where it's all cosplay inspired wigs, and you can get wigs from from TV shows like Game of Thrones. You can also custom make your own wigs as well, which is what I have done here. But you can also sort through wigs in the way of style, whether you want them to be curly, wavy, straight, short, medium, long. You can also sort by color, and they've got a wide range of different colors within the colors. For example, if you click on blonde or red, you will get wigs that range from ash blonde to golden blonde to dark blonde. You will get wigs that range from like a natural auburn to an aerial red, and you can even find some orange wigs in there too. They have a ton of wigs, all at very affordable prices, and they actually have an Australian website now as well, so I will post the link to them down below. Now this wig here I had custom made for me, so it was a little bit more expensive. If you are a fan of the Barbie films, you will recognize this wig immediately. It is from the film Princess Power. Now I will put a photo here. I cosplayed as Super Sparkle a couple of years ago at the Gold Coast Convention Center for Supernova. I think it might have been 2018 that I went as Super Sparkle, but I'm not certain. Could have been 2017 as well. I know it was the same weekend that Andrew and I became official. So it might have actually been 2017 that I went to this convention. But Super Sparkle, I'll post a picture of her here from the movie, has normal blonde hair. She's Barbie, obviously, and then when she transforms into Super Sparkle, she gets the pink streaks through it. Now, Super Sparkle's hair is actually up in a ponytail, and the one thing that I will mention is that when I sent reference photos to the customer service team of Wig Is Fashion, I sent reference photos of her with her updo, so I did actually expect this wig to arrive like that. I thought it would come as a ponytail, but it didn't, and I don't have the right wig tape or wig glue in order to hold it down and then be able to style it myself up into a high pony, but it is definitely possible to do. But as you can see, I don't have the wig down properly, so my sideburns would show. But I do eventually plan on figuring out how to attach this properly to my head so that I can restyle it up into a ponytail, because someone is speeding. Because Super Sparkle does actually have her hair up in a ponytail when she is saving the day. And as you can probably tell from the reference photo I showed you before, this is near perfect. So in the Barbie world, they kind of don't have layers with their hair. It's sort of, it goes blonde, and then their colored streak, which is usually pink for Barbie, blonde, pink, blonde, pink. But with this one, it is all throughout. So it's not just one section is blonde, one section is pink. It kind of all meshes together so that it's looking natural, and I quite enjoy that. It is very long, so I will stand up and show you. So it goes to about my belly button, which is right there. So it's very, very long, and when I'm able to put it up into a ponytail, I think it will look beautiful. But I wanted to come on here and I wanted to showcase this to you guys because I love watching wig reviews. I love doing wig reviews. I'll post some links up above to some other ones that I have done for Wig Is Fashion. And this one I haven't worn a lot. It is actually one of my least knotty wigs because I don't get to wear it often. But I wanted to come on here and I wanted to show you guys because I love this one so much. I think it suits me really well, which is really surprising. I have been a lot of hair colors in the past, mostly reds, but I have also tried to go blonde. I tried to go like a Sleeping Beauty sunshine gold blonde a while back, and it kind of turned my hair orange. So I kind of shied away from going blonde. And the only way that I will ever be blonde is by wearing wigs, because I'm just too scared to dye my hair any color but red. And obviously I'm growing my hair out at the moment for my natural color. But I wanted to come on here and I wanted to show you guys this wig. Now, it is synthetic and it is thick and sturdy. It is durable. It is beautifully made. I love how they've done the part. It's kind of just a little bit here, but you are able to adjust the wig. So if you wanted this part more over here, or if you wanted it more over there, you just kind of have to move the wig. It's still going to look fantastic. I love the length. And their wigs are super high in quality. It doesn't matter that it's not human hair. I think that sometimes getting human hair is a little bit of a waste of money. I think the only reason getting a human hair wig is great is because you're able to style it with heat. However, Wiggers Fashion wigs do allow you to heat them up to a certain temperature. Everything is in the description box on the website. Now, I cannot remember how much this cost me to get made. I want to say it was maybe about 100, 120 Australian dollars, but it was about 80, 88 American dollars at the time, because back when I bought this, they didn't have their Australian website up. So I had to go to the general one. But I love it. I think it is so beautiful. It is a lace front and I have cut it, and I'm not sure if you can see it on camera, but it is my kind of natural skin tone, so it blends in wonderfully well. I also love that the hairline that they've given this wig is quite natural, so that it doesn't look too much like a wig. Obviously, because I don't have it sitting down properly, if wind were to pick it up or if I was to kind of brush it out of the way, you'd be able to tell it was a wig. But there is enough lace front here that if I secure it to my skull properly, I will be able to hide the fact that it's a wig. I just need to find the right products for that, and I prefer to use glue over tape because I found in the past that tape lifts easily. So if you know of a really good quality glue that's not super expensive, please let me know down in the comments below. But yes, I just wanted to come on here and show you this wig and give you a quick review, because it is one of my favorite wigs. It is so beautiful. It's so well made. The customer service team were really, really great in their communication. I was never waiting more than 2 days to hear back from them. They did send me quite a few reference pictures that they had drawn up at the time, before I approved of it. Again, the only setback for me was that I did think it would come up, like it would arrive as a ponytail, but it didn't. But that's okay, because I think I can do that myself. I just need to figure out how to attach the wig to my head properly first. But yes, so it does come, like all their wigs, in a plastic sleeve, and each wig is also wrapped up in one of these black hairnets. And I definitely recommend, whether you're going to keep your wigs in their plastic sleeve or put them on a foam head — I thought I had it behind me, but it's over there — you definitely want to put the black netting over the top. This just tends to leave all the, like, the loose hairs in place, and prevents it from getting knotty. I don't know how it does it. Maybe it's like some sort of static thing, but these are wonderful. You'll also notice that a lot of women in the 1930s, 40s, 50s, even the 19th century, if they did their hair up, they would always put, almost always, put their hair in a net, and it just kind of kept everything in place. It wouldn't have been black unless their hair was black. It was usually, the netting was like the same color as the hair, but it just keeps everything in place. So these are fantastic. It just makes it stay straight or curly or wavy without getting knots in it. And yeah, that's basically all, guys. As I said, I just wanted to come on here and showcase this wig, talk about it a little bit, because I wore it today for the first time in a very long time, and I thought, you know what, I love Wiggers Fashion. I love buying from them. I have tons of their wigs up in my wig closet, and I never actually came on here to talk about this one. So yes, I will post all of Wiggers Fashion's links down below, including the Australian website, so that you can check it out. They have some fantastic stock. They do sales all the time. I think about once a month they add new wigs, so there are never ending options on their site. Everything is very well priced. As I said, these are synthetic wigs, so they're going to be a lot cheaper than human hair wigs, significantly a lot cheaper. I think human hair wigs can go for $200 to $300, and I do think Wiggers Fashion does offer human hair wigs, but I don't think it's necessary, because their synthetic wigs are of fantastic quality. they look like real hair. When I went to the convention all those years back, I had so many people compliment my wig, thinking it was my actual hair because it just looks like it could be. And yeah, so that's it guys. I hope you liked this video. Let me know down below what your favorite wig site is to buy wigs. And if you are a Wiggers fashion girl like me, let me know what your favorite wig of theirs is down below. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.